Okay, I'm hoping we're online. I'm not sure whether we are or not. Let's see how we do. This cast is working, and I have a suspicion it might not be. I'm going to stop for a moment here, if I can. Here's the central station. I'm looking down towards the Town Hall Square. Father Christmas on top of the town hall. And the temporary pub, the Pig and Barrel, part of the temporary market in the centre of Manchester. Full of taxis again, we can't see a thing. It's been very successful this year so far, apparently. I just hope this is working. The big wheel's going around tonight as well. See that in the distance, I think. Or you should be able to. says Road Ahead closed, but I don't think it is. Through here during the day because of the bollards. The big wheel is definitely going round tonight. Where's he going? Any of those famous bollards that shoot up and catch people. Sure which way this truck's going. So it's in the middle of the lane. Going straight on after all. It wasn't clear, wasn't that? Now I was in the wrong lane as well, I suppose. Hi Lithium, is the cast working? Can you tell me if the cast's working, please? Can you tell me if it's working properly? I can't tell. I have a feeling it's not doing very well. Is it working okay? Or is it jerky? Yeah, I thought I might have. Might go off altogether now. We're under a bridge. You see the cathedral clock over there? Under the bridge? A white circle? And to the left of it is number 1 Deansgate. That building with the lights on the left, that's number 1 Deansgate. Just past the cathedral now. Harvey Nichols. And this is Deansgate. Oh, the lights change. They never do when you want them to. I'm going slowly to try and get the lights to show better. Big store on the right with decorations all over it. Stop here for a moment and let you see this. We're on double yellow lines, but never mind. That should have let the lights come into focus, I think. Would change with somebody in front of me, wouldn't they? Great. What's it like now? Is it reasonable? Pub on the left, all absolutely covered in little lights. You can probably see it. See the pub on the left of the bridge, all covered in little lights. absolutely smothered in them. The Meatham Tower has also got lights in the basement as well, in the bottom of it, which you can probably see now, I think. Passing Granada TV studios. Well, it's not very good in the city centre anyway, in places, there's buildings and that all around which interfere with it. Seem to be following a lot of Volvos tonight. I don't know why that is.
Imagine take one or the Aviator, for example.
Is there any sign of my bot Cabana at the moment? Is she in the channel or not? She wasn't earlier. Any sign of Cobana?
Because it's that the problem has been the stigma of commercial gimmicks.
Manchester United is behind us now. It's in a place called Trafford Park. I think it's actually in Salford, oddly enough.
Referenced so many films just as we've been talking here for a short while, and there's often a quality of looking back, celebrating, but also some people say slightly mournful quality about you looking back to the early years of cinema in Hugo. Do you think that we're now at a point in films where we can't escape the past, we're always looking back? Is there still somewhere to go?
Why are we always looking back? Because up to now we can see. In other words, it's there. But the young person born on the day, they don't know that a Devil Clementine or American in Paris or the Seventh Seal was made.
We're actually heading in the direction of the City Stadium, but you want to see it now. It won't be lit up tonight. We're just passing the arena at the moment. Manchester Arena. Has only got one light.
But I know that you can't stop it, except for some incredible disaster, I think. But young people, whether they're twittering, tweeting, I guess, I don't know what that is. Anyway, I think, and whether they're doing it in my mom and...
I'm a suspicion, I've got a headlight out, actually.
Or whether they're making a film about it, I don't know, I thought that would be shown to the people in villages that can't...
I might have.
This time.
From the way his number plate is lighting up, I think I've got the right hand headlights out.
Defending this, but we did have reserve seats for certain films, whether it was Todd A.O. films or Ben-Hur or even The Bridge on the River Kwai. There was a reserve seat engagement when it was first released. So there was something, just don't walk in and sit down and watch the film.
Yes, I have a suspicion I've got a headlight out.
Special experience. The problem is we have to come up with that special experience creatively. That's the difference. And there will be some people who will never want to put those glasses on. And I mean, I don't really blame them if they don't want to. And they can see the same version in 2D. However, the issue here is that part of the new technology will be without the glasses.
Talk about the blurring of the lines between the small and the big screen, or home cinema, bigger, small screens. You've been working on the boardwalk in the Halle for the small screen.
Well, I certainly feel the case of what we can learn from the series is several people got up and insisted that the film be shown in a theater because of the communal experience of a film that is a non-fiction film. Now, that's interesting.
Finally, I wanted to ask you that music, because it is one of the great loves of life. The Last Waltz is being re-released here. That's interesting. And 1978, that kind of film would be following the band in the right kind of architecture film about a great rock band with Bob Dylan, fantastic cast of rock stars. How can you watch that film now? How do you watch it?
Yes, I think my driver's side front headlight is out. I'm sure it is.
Only lasts a certain amount of time. I'd like to
Hi, Pedro.
Yeah, put it this way. But the irony that supposedly is part of this world right now, or the past 15, 20 years, I'm not interested. Because at a certain point, you have to take things seriously, even with humor, seriously. At a certain point in your life, you can't. If you say, I love you, you've got to mean it. There's no irony there. Whether you can follow through on it or not, that's another issue. So in the case of The Last Waltz, we didn't know it was going to be a valedictory film in a sense, or even I should put it this way. We didn't really understand that it was also a film which was a film that would be associated with the end of time. The end of a certain time, there's no doubt about that. However, it carries through over time. It's universal because the work itself is not what I'm talking about.
I'm just going to stop in a minute and have a look at my headlights. So I think one's out. Be wrong about this, but I have a suspicion one's out.
Baseball cap. I never wear a baseball cap. You know, I'm going to get robbed if I get it. But when I see him in LA, so I ever go there again. But he's very funny. But no, the Spinal Tap is one of the great. I still use the Everybody Does. So turn it up to 11. Yes, exactly. That we're doing on the set with the 3D. I said, can you give me? I said, what if we go? What are we like? You're at 4 now. What if we go to 7 or something? It's so laughing.
Well, there was no traffic when I stopped, and there's loads now.
Right.
Have a quick look.
We've been looking at creative peaks when artists and writers have produced their best work. Certainly, classical repertoire reverberates to the sounds of early genius. Chopin composed some of his finest works as a teenager,
They both are. They're both still on It's an Illusion.
Music Matters presenter and Guardian writer Tom Service and critic David Hepburn are both here with me. David, we just heard Martin Scorsese again talking about The Last Waltz. Many of that
comes from... Let's get back on the move again.
5 years on. Did some of them win 5 years ago?
Well, I think you could say that they peaked in terms of creating their core repertoire when they were quite young. But nobody envisaged, and certainly they didn't envisage it until The Last Waltz in the film, was that they kind of, that would become a template for kind of classic rock, which now flourishes even more today than it ever has done before. And so, you know, that was the kind of end of an absolute universe, which traditionally was the most ephemeral possible.
Christmas lights are not on.
Yes,
they're on the lamps, but they're not turned on.
Yeah, I mean, it does not.
Radio 3 and put some music, and guess what? They're talking. Oh well. Cobana here. Can anybody tell me if Cobana's here? That's the bot. K-O-B-A-N-A. Cobana. I've not been able to check. Degrees outside at the moment. She's here. Bit annoying. Library and Learning Centre. I thought that was a Tesco. That's interesting. I think the library and the Learning Centre have been built by Tesco, to be honest. No point in rushing because the other lights are at red. Great. Lights yet, that is a surprise. Oh, hang on. There's one. The Santa Claus is up, but not switched on yet. What's the video like at the moment? Is it showing reasonably clearly or not? Are we jerking all over the place again? There will be some Christmas lights on these houses at the end shortly. There aren't at the moment, but there will be before long. And there were some on down here when we came out, but I don't think they're still on now. I think they've turned them off. I can't see them anyway. Shortly. When I say shortly, they won't be on, you won't be able to see them tonight. Right, okay. Cabana's missing. Okay, Lithium, thanks for watching. I'm shutting down for now. Okay, good night to you. Sleep well. I'm shutting down now.